Another busy afternoon. What have we got here?
Yes. I'll be there in 5 minutes.
What? Room change?
Guys, we've had a high temperature insulated beverage receptacle deposited in a legal position.
How long has it been here?
Forensics haven't gone back to us yet.
Get it here. Still warm. Can't have been here long. Interview all six formers.
But Mum, we don't have the resources.
Just get it done.
Are these even real actors? God, dear.
So I heard some people talk about going to Glastonbury this year.
Oh yeah, I'm going, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. We're just flying in on the helicopter on
the Friday.
Oh, they've
got a helipad, great. Yeah. That was always my concern, that it was the traffic and
oh yeah, don't be with those people. God, there's queues.
But when we hired Beyonce to do my birthday party, I had a chat with her. She said she'd enjoyed doing Glastonbury. There are a lot of commoners there, she said.
Yeah, no, and actually, one wants to be in the sort of, you know, high-profile
well,
area.
Well, exactly. I mean, when I hung out with Bono just before they did it, we talked about charity and that kind of the African... Is it a charity Africa? I'm never quite sure he goes on about it when we meet up.
No, it can't... Is it? Yeah, maybe.
Is it about kids and starving?
Yeah, sure.
I mean, I was famished at the time.
Oh, now that is rubbish.
I've had enough of it. Turn it off! Turn it off!
George Nolan, failing to attend registration
in a groundbreaking
assembly,
new documentary, we uncover the hidden life of the unsung hero of the NOT. Watch as we try to discover just how much of her time is wasted by students and what really happens behind the sixth form office doors.
No one in detention again.
This is Life on the Front Line.
Hello, Helen Fisher.
It's 9:35 in the sixth form office, and once again, no one has turned up to assembly. It's looking like a busy day for the deputy head of Year 13. The students are cunning in their attempts to evade her watchful eye, but Mrs. Fisher is well practiced in deciding who is to be trusted.
Assembly?
Hi, Miss.
Assembly?
Yeah, Mr.
Garton
spoke.
Yeah, but you weren't there.
About the 94.
Yeah, well, were you there?
Yeah.
You've been marked absent by your tutor.
Must be.
Tell me a bit more about the assembly.
I can't, because I wasn't there.
That'll be a detention, Alan.
So, have you still got that person who was...
Well, my housekeeper.
Yeah.
But, I mean, she's got to go. I mean, she mixed up the stainless steel and the silver.
You know, I heard about that. That was pretty awful, wasn't it?
Well, I mean, you know, you'd think you'd know the difference. For goodness sake.
Didn't you have some people come round?
Yeah, it was so embarrassing. Can you imagine?
And wasn't there a mix-up with the champagne as well? You got the
Prosecco, champagne.
Oh, well, goodness.
Everyone knows the difference.
And you've got some nice 67, haven't you?
Yeah.
Why didn't we get that out last time?
And then she didn't decant the port properly. I mean, you know, it's just appalling.
If you don't let it breathe, to be honest, it's undrinkable.
I was so embarrassed. I mean, you know,
I've sometimes thought you should have spent a bit more on it. But I never really wanted to say.
What?
But even the cheap stuff, if you let it breathe and decanter, tastes a bit better. A couple of people had said last time they came around for drinks at yours.
It wasn't cheap.
You call that acting? No good. No good.
After psychology.
One of the ways Mrs. Fisher picks up after the students is by returning the books left scattered around the sixth form common room and in her office. You'd think that the so-called adults attending the sixth form would be capable of returning textbooks themselves, but apparently not. Mrs. Fisher has some very interesting theories about who are the worst culprits.
Yeah, I frequently have to take textbooks back to the department. They're lying around the sixth form common room or just casually discarded by the students. Always have to take textbooks back. Economics books and psychology books more than any other. So those students must be the most forgetful.
Thank you.
I don't know who it was, but
okay.
This is my office.
Another job done, and Mrs. Fisher moves on to her next task. It's exam time at the Cherwell School, and the sixth form staff have had to relocate to the upper room above the study. Mrs. Fisher is an invaluable member of the team, and as such, you would expect that she would get suitable facilities to complete her work. But it seems this is not the case.
How many
I hate being up here.
It is
really the worst time of my year moving up here because there's not enough space and it's too hot, which causes me a lot of problems.
Yeah.
It's too hot. And the air conditioning currently is not working. Well, there isn't air conditioning in here anyway, there's just windows, but it's not really not hot. And it's too noisy, and it's difficult to concentrate. And at the moment, we don't have a phone, and we didn't have a print, although that is now fixed. But most other people like it up here, but I hate it up here.
It's almost the end of school, and Mrs. Fisher's day has been a very busy one, but it's not over yet. It's 2:56, and Mrs. Fisher still has to find four people for detention. Before 3:05 p.m. It's a race against time, and she must act fast.
George Nolan, failing to attend registration assembly. Overslept, missed a lesson.
That's it.
Yeah. Got detention.
Oh, no.
Detention again.
Detention,
oh,
and actually on film
my mom will
got
kill
detention.
Me.
Oh. Chris, come in, sit down. Right, got to ask you a few questions. I've seen you use the Costa coffee downstairs. Can you tell me what your drink preference is down there?
Usually mocha.
What's mocha?
Hot chocolate with coffee.
Oh, right, okay.
And some tea.
And tea,
yeah.
Occasionally, right. Tell me about this. Do the initials TS mean anything to you?
No.
You sure?
Positive.
Why do you think they're there?
I don't know.
You don't know. Think very carefully, because anything that you do or don't say may have consequences if you're not entirely honest with us.
Come quickly, we found more evidence.
I gathered CCTV footage from the crime scene. I was particularly interested in this frame.
Can we enhance this photo?
I thought I tried every technique, but I came up with a new recursive C++ visual algorithm that bitmaps the reflection vectors from epidermal tissue in the EM spectrum.
Can we run that now?
One step ahead of you.
That's...
I know.
Is that
a reflection? If we use a polynomial inflexive absorption spectrum ray map, we can extract an image from that reflection.
Can you increase the detail?
I'm enhancing it now.
I've cracked it. It's not a student.
That's a member of staff.
Costa. I always knew she was off her mocker.
Gardening's great. Yours try it. I grow beans and tomatoes. Very good. Love beans, green beans, broad beans, French beans, climbers, dwarf, marvellous beans. Can't beat enough beans. Green beans, generally.
Is that just a minute,
that? Well, you cook them. So then slightly al dente, slather them in butter with a bit of salt and pepper. Asparagus,
or,
I'm going
to
pick your own.
You can roast them in olive oil.
Asparagus. It does have a tendency, though, to make your wee smell.
Doesn't with me.
It does with me. After I've eaten asparagus, I smell like a horse.